PayPal has broken up with their parent company, eBay. PayPal and eBay are now two separate companies. They're going to have brand new CEOs for each one. Just pretty huge shakeup. PayPal is going to be an independent company with their own shares, their own stocks and everything like that. Supposedly, it's gonna enable both companies to focus better on their respective markets. So eBay wants to keep innovating in the marketplace area, and PayPal wants to keep innovating in like the payments area. And eBay is obviously an online marketplace, but PayPal, a lot of observers are saying that PayPal wants to focus more and more on in-person payments. Now that everyone has smartphones, the mobile payment space is quickly evolving with things like Bitcoin, with things like Apple Pay came out recently, and PayPal wants to be really nimble in tackling this area, and they don't want to be hamstrung by a parent company that isn't fully dedicated to the payment space. So that's why they That's the main reason why they are kind of splitting up, but it kind of explains a little bit why they've embraced Bitcoin so much and all these like kind of new methods of payments and new marketing campaign and all this. Like, I think they've been planning for a while this split, and they're kind of trying to reinvent themselves by being their own company, by embracing Bitcoin, by using this one-touch payment system that is trying to compete with Apple Pay. And I mean, it's a really good move. It's what they kind of needed to do to stay competitive in this space, because PayPal was kind of starting to go the way of the dinosaur, starting to get a little bit obsolete compared to competitors out there. And now, being an independent company, they'll be able to innovate faster, focus more on what they want to do, and hopefully focus more on Bitcoin, integrate Bitcoin more deeply into PayPal. So, what do you think about this brand new split?
I was gonna say pretty much the same thing you said. Like, what if PayPal took so long to start or integrating Bitcoin with its putting them back?
Because of eBay.
Yeah. So maybe now that PayPal is an independent company, they might be a little bit more aggressive in their Bitcoin integration, which would be pretty cool. But you know what? I actually didn't know that eBay owned PayPal.
Oh yeah.
Somehow that like went right over my head, like completely got past me. Yeah, I didn't know that, so that's pretty interesting to me at least.
Yeah, I think, well, PayPal was independent a long time ago, years and years ago. I think they were founded in like 1998. Founded by Elon Musk. He was a co-founder.
Really?
Yeah.
I didn't know that either.
Yeah, Elon Musk did PayPal before he did Tesla. And, then sold it to investors. I'm not sure if he sold it to investors and then they sold it to eBay, or if he sold directly to eBay. I'd have to look that up. But yeah, it eventually got in the hands of eBay. eBay bought them because eBay wanted to integrate them deeper into their own marketplace and all that. But like now, like they kind of outgrown each other in a way, eBay wants to do their own thing more, and PayPal wants to do their own thing more, and look deeper into Bitcoin. And now PayPal is its own company again. Now there's a lot of speculation going on in the financial world about whether investors should invest in PayPal now that they can buy dedicated PayPal stocks. And it really depends on what we see come out of PayPal in the very near future. Now that they are their own company, are they going to innovate faster? Are they going to create new innovative ways of, person-to-person payments? Are they going to lower their fees a little bit, to stay competitive with Apple Pay and Bitcoin? So it really depends on what comes out of this and what they're gonna do with their newfound freedom. But it's a good sign. It's a really good sign. I'm like, in general, I'm a huge supporter of like when companies kind of split up into separate companies and become more nimble in their individual pieces rather than just being just one big gigantic blob of conglomerate, services and stuff like that, which is a huge flaw that we always keep seeing in the telecommunications industry. Monopolies always happening. So it's nice to see, for once, a large, tech internet commerce company kind of split up so that both sides can pursue their goals in more targeted ways. So I think it's pretty good.
Right, specialization always makes things more efficient. If you just have one, giant firm that controls everything, they're not going to be able to run things efficiently as if you had, like 10 smaller firms each doing one thing. So yeah, it's probably great for both eBay and PayPal because. When they were one company, eBay was probably, may have had a lot of trouble because, there were conflicting interests there. Like PayPal wanted to do one thing, but doing that might have hurt eBay. eBay
Yeah.
wanted to do one thing, but doing that might have hurt PayPal. Well, now they can just both do whatever they want without hurting each other at all, and that's great. And I hope PayPal does more with Bitcoin because PayPal right now is, the most popular online payment platform. So the more they do with Bitcoin, the more it gets out there to people who wouldn't even know it exists.
Yeah.
There's a lot of great potential for Bitcoin, but no matter what PayPal does with Bitcoin, it's really great for PayPal as a company. So
Yeah, and hopefully we see like brand new innovative features that PayPal can create with Bitcoin that we don't see anywhere else in the Bitcoin ecosystem. Like in the past few weeks, like we've talked about all the other PayPal developments, they have enabled certain merchants to accept Bitcoin through PayPal for like digital goods and services and small things like that, small subsidiaries of PayPal like Braintree. And now, that's just a minor thing. We talked about that. That's just really a minor thing, but it's a sign
yeah, I
of things to
still don't
come.
even know what Braintree is.
It's like a feature. It's a feature. Like basically a merchant can insert the Braintree code into their website, and that allows them to accept payments for their thing. It's like a payment processor that's supposed to be really like simple and easy to implement, but not a lot of people use it. It's just like only a few thousand merchants or something. And then
Okay.
the payments hub integration, which we talked about last week, adds another few thousand merchants. But like they have to opt in to the Bitcoin acceptance. Like they have to create an account with Coinbase and such. So it's just minor developments, and it's like it creates nice headlines in the Bitcoin community and in the tech community, but like it's just really super minor features at this point. I am
Right.
really, really looking forward to seeing what PayPal comes up with that's really original in terms of actually managing Bitcoin transactions and managing Bitcoin balances. Like the moment we see PayPal integrate Bitcoin into their full-blown PayPal application, that's when things get really interesting. 'Cause then they can compete directly with Coinbase, maybe even compete directly with Circle. They can compete with Circle and maybe enable instant Bitcoin purchasing right within PayPal instead of having to go on localbitcoins.com and paying someone through there with PayPal for Bitcoins. So there's a lot of possibilities, and I'm sure they're looking into these.
I hope they make a decent Bitcoin debit card. Because I'm still hurt about Zappo. I was so excited about Zappo and they let me down.
Yeah.
So, PayPal, counting on you.
Well, I mean, I mentioned this in an earlier podcast. PayPal does have like their own kind of debit card service where you can get a debit card with them. I'll show it right here. I won't show my actual number, but I have it right here. Like you can link it directly with your PayPal account, and if you have money in your PayPal account, you can send it directly to the bank account associated with this card, and then boom, your PayPal funds are spendable on this card. And it's this little thing right here. This is the PayPal debit card, and this is basically what I use when I convert my Bitcoin payments into fiat. Just go on localbitcoins.com and sell my Bitcoins to someone who is using PayPal to pay me. Then boom, that's money in my PayPal account, and then I can instantly just go on the website and transfer it from my PayPal account to the debit card. So that's a solution. It just takes a few steps, but it's like the best solution right now that's available for transferring Bitcoin money into a debit card, and it works pretty well. They just need to kind of streamline it. It'd be good if they streamlined it and kind of made it easier. Like if this pulled directly from your PayPal account without having to transfer it manually on the website, that would be good. That'd be really awesome. But right now, I think it's the best option.
Well, I think, in terms of Bitcoin integration, they just need like a dedicated card, and they can create, they can create an online wallet, an online Bitcoin wallet, and then it'd be like Zappo does, if we had access to Zappo, that's how it would work. But it just, at the point of sale, it takes your Bitcoins, sells them on the exchange, deposits the fiat into the company's bank account, or whatever kind of account. That'd be so much easier than, selling them on local Bitcoins than transferring it from PayPal to this debit card, or even debit card directly accessible to your PayPal account. It'd be even easier than that. And so that's something giving you that's a freebie, PayPal. When you start integrating Bitcoin more fully, do that, and
Do
you'll
it.
be super rich. And I won't charge a finder's fee, so I'll just buy one of your debit cards.